Welcome back to another episode of Rock Boys Football. While a lot of college football fans are preoccupied with what's going on in the transfer portal, Mike Elko and the Texas A&M Aggies continue to roll on the high school recruiting trail, landing another commitment in three-star offensive lineman Connor Carty from the state of Texas. I have written in my notes after watching the film last night on Connor Carty, bar fight guy. What I mean by that is this dude is absolutely nasty. And if I was in a scrap at a bar, I'd want Connor Carty on my side. This kid fires me up. And I think you see Texas A&M doing a really good job in the state of Texas on the offensive line. That was the position that we would really like to see take a step, not only from a recruiting standpoint, but from a development standpoint too. We kind of believe that Adam Cushing can get it done on the developmental side. You're starting to see the talent coming as well. Marcus Garcia committing on Sunday. Want to get into the film of Connor Carty, talk a little bit about what he brings to this Texas A&M program. Before we do, and as always, just want to say thank you to you guys. Massive shout out to the Texas A&M fans. Whether we're talking this program on the recruiting trail, in the transfer portal, y'all always show a ton of love to the fellas. Cannot thank you guys enough. If y'all do enjoy the content, consider subscribing to the channel. And without further ado, let's get into Connor Carty. Now, taking a look at the athletic profile, this is kind of how you want your interior offensive lineman built, right? 6'4", 290 pounds going into his senior year. He's got a shot put background in the track and field. And similar to Marcus Garcia, you see the shot put discus background show up on the football field, right? Really, really strong lower body, plays with good pads, an explosive kid off the line of scrimmage, right? And that kind of translates over from participating in the shot put and discus events on the track and field. And again, I think my overarching take on Connor Carty, going back to how I opened this one as a bar fight kind of guy, he's nasty. He has an attitude. This is one of those guys that you want on your team, on your offensive line, because he is always looking for work. He's a very, very physical, aggressive guy on the football field. I think that's what Mike Elko is trying to get more of on this Texas A&M offensive line. I want to take a dive into his film and kind of show you guys and get a sense of what he brings to this Texas A&M program. And again, the first couple of reps, you're going to see just nasty, nasty, nasty in terms of finishing blocks, being very, very aggressive. Those are all the things that you want to see at the high school level. Really good off the line of scrimmage, always plays with good pad levels. You see how explosive he is off the line, playing with good pads, really at his best in these kind of situations where he's just kind of washing down block and just taking guys and kind of putting them in the dirt. This is a really impressive rep where you kind of see the athleticism that Connor Carty has too, right? We kind of talked about, I think the first thing to love about Connor Carty is that he is a guy that is extremely powerful. He's extremely explosive, aggressive, can get going in the run game. He's also a guy that can work up to the second level, shows really, really quick feet for somebody who is 290 pounds as put together as he is. I mean, this is kind of some textbook blocking right here from Connor Carty. Probably my favorite rep on the film, where he gets super aggressive, wins at the line of scrimmage on a double team, gets up to the second level, puts the linebacker in the dirt. You watch that back again. Like, I don't know if you could draw that up any better, right? Extremely explosive out of the stance, and this double team completely washed the 78, puts him in the dirt, works up to 35. That second level defender popping a big one for his running back. That is exactly how you want it to look. And again, Connor Carty does a really good job working up to the second level, which is kind of rare when you look at offensive linemen. A lot of them really big can win at the line of scrimmage at the high school ranks. Are they athletic enough to work up to the second level, get to linebackers and safeties? Connor Carty certainly can do that. You see a little nasty with them, super powerful hands. A lot of different ways that you can get Connor Carty involved. But if you look at kind of the boxes that you want to see checked, nasty, powerful, athletic. Those are kind of the three boxes that you're looking for from interior offensive linemen coming from the high school ranks. And you take a look at what Texas A&M is doing in this 2025 class, and I am a massive fan of what Mike Elko is building, right? You bring in Hassan Longstreet, a guy that y'all know I am extremely high on. He's the quarterback that if Texas A&M does something, in my mind, really special over the next 3 to 4 years, it's going to be, in my mind, with Hassan Longstreet as your quarterback. But you scroll down on the offensive side of the football, doing a really good job. DeAndre Ridden, we already talked about, Marcus Garcia. You add a guy in Connor Carty addressing the line of scrimmage, a guy in Landon Rink, who I think is going to finish this as a four-star. He is a really, really impressive out of Cypress, Texas. And Texas A&M, top 15 class in the country, trending for a lot of talent in this 2025 class. And just a quick conversation, we covered this yesterday, but what Texas A&M is doing on the transfer portal side of things as well. And that's kind of the conversation that we have, is how well can you balance getting it done on the recruiting trail, but also supplementing your roster in the transfer portal. You're seeing Mike Elko and the staff, in my mind, do a very good job of that. And that's kind of the modern day of how you build rosters in college football. You have to use the transfer portal. It is something that is extremely valuable, but you don't want to overdo the transfer portal where your high school recruiting is kind of falling to the wayside. I think you're seeing Mike Elko in a short time in College Station really blend those two together to really get this roster in a good spot heading into 2024. Now, two transfer portal targets that I want to talk about. One, Solomon DeShields coming over from Pitt. Yesterday we talked about, you know, potentially adding an experienced linebacker that's played a lot at the Power 5 level. You have Torian York. We all know he is going to be an all-SEC kind of guy, but after that, you kind of have question marks about the experience at that linebacker spot. Solomon DeShields, I mean, this is going into his fifth year, played at Pitt, really, really solid last year, 58 tackles, 8 tackles for a loss. What I love the most, really good pass rusher. And we know Texas A&M, they're going to want to use their linebackers as weapons. Solomon DeShields can get after in the pass rush department. So this is a guy that I think gives that linebacker room a higher floor, but also a guy that can be a weapon in this Texas A&M offense and or defense, excuse me. Now moving to the offensive side of the football, my favorite wide receiver in the portal, Keandre Lambert-Smith. And we kind of said that I don't know if Texas A&M will get super aggressive in the portal for a wide receiver unless it's going to be a wide receiver one caliber guy. That, in my mind, is what Keandre Lambert-Smith is. Y'all know I'm a Michigan fan. I'm very familiar with Keandre Lambert-Smith coming from Penn State. This was a guy that, I mean, he's probably going to the NFL draft right now, having caught for 1,000 yards back-to-back seasons if he had a better quarterback and a better offense that he was a part of. Really, really exciting proposition for Keandre Lambert-Smith to come to Texas A&M. And then already what is a loaded wide receiver room, and kind of just add another weapon to this offense. And why I like this fit so much is, and Keandre Lambert-Smith can do a lot of different things, right? 35% of his snaps as a slot, 75% as the boundary. He gets used in a lot of different ways. He's not, quote unquote, a one-trick pony. The thing that he does best is just create separation. This is a guy that's a clean route runner. You have guys that specialize in certain things, right? Cyrus Allen working vertically down the field. You have guys like Moose Muhammad, Jabari Barber, kind of your slot separators, yards after the catch. And Keandre Lambert-Smith kind of comes in, is like, hey, I'm just a all-around polished wide receiver. You can get me involved in a lot of different ways. And quite frankly, I think has the upside potentially to be the best wide receiver in this Texas A&M wide receiver room. And I mean, that's me saying a lot. Y'all know how I feel about Texas A&M's wide receiver room heading into 2024. We'll keep our eyes on those two names. Connor Carty to commit into Texas A&M. Very nice pickup for the Aggies. Appreciate y'all rocking with the fellas. If you guys do enjoy the content, consider subscribing to the channel. Appreciate you guys, and we'll talk to y'all later.